Good morning, everybody. Father Bill Holtzinger here, pastor of Holy Trinity Catholic Church in Beaverton, Oregon, and this is your Friday reflection. I'm in what is called the conference room. So I did a little twist here. This is our conference room in the offices. This used to be a house, and there's Snickers there hanging out. And I just got done with Mass on, this is Thursday as I'm recording this. Well, you know, we're just not perfect people. And if it's not obvious, at least, why watching me, then I don't know what you, I don't know what you're paying attention to. But okay, so why do I say that? So today, which is again Thursday, is the obligatory memorial of St. Justin Martyr. Now you may not know that, but I know that, and I was preparing for that and had a homily printed up and ready to go. And then I proceed to get on my chasuble and march out and offer Mass. And yeah, so nobody noticed anything except maybe one. And that was, someone noticed that I was wearing green. Now you might think, okay, green, that's fine. Green is ordinary time, right? But it was Justin Martyr. It was a Martyr's Day. And what color should I be wearing then? Red. I wasn't wearing red. Okay, who cares, right? Well, the idea of liturgy is supposed to image what is the, what's going on, who we are celebrating, etc. And I didn't even notice that until it was noted after Mass. Somebody did notice that themselves, that one person, thank God. Yeah. But then, as I like to wear the chasubles and kind of hug up to the my neck, is kind of how they're supposed to be worn. And as I do this, the chasuble kind of comes up and goes like right up against my chin. I'm like, what? As I feel back, it's really, it's thinner in the back and it's thicker on this front, on the part that I'm having in the front here. That's called a cowl, by the way. And then I realize, oh my goodness, I'm wearing my chasuble backwards. Not only you got the wrong color, I'm wearing it backwards. Nobody knows that I'm wearing it backwards. So I did, there's a couple of sisters from the local religious communities that were here, and I mentioned this to them, and they had a good laugh, and other people. And that's okay. You know what? I don't mind goofing up, and I do appreciate all of your patience with me. Maybe I need to get up earlier. I don't know. I get up pretty early at 5 a.m., and I just, I don't know, maybe I need to get up dead earlier. But, you know, I'm not a morning person, and so when I get up, I make lots of logic errors and goofy things, and there you go. That's just an example of some of those for me. So, moving on to this weekend. This weekend is going to be the Solemnity of our church, the feast day of our parish church, Holy Trinity. Now, as I'm working on my homily, I'm reflecting on this idea that we become like what we worship. We become like what we worship. And that begs the question, what do we worship? Who do we worship? Now, as the Trinity, we believe very simply that God is one and yet three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Yes, this is a great mystery, and I'm not going to even attempt to describe it today and probably not do very much a good job on Sunday, because this is one of those topics where you can say more things wrong than right. So my hope is to apply this for us in our lives. How can we live out the imitation of the Trinity in our lives? That's kind of where I'm going with this. So that's what we're doing. But I'm asking you to think about, who do you pray to when you are praying? Do you pray to the Father or the Son or the Holy Spirit? And I mentioned this in the homily last week when I was encouraging everybody to pray to the Holy Trinity, to the Holy Spirit, because it was, right, it was Pentecost. So we're in this time of multiple feast days. So Pentecost, we have then this coming weekend, Holy Trinity, and then following that, Corpus Christi. These are great feast days that kind of begin or restart the ordinary time. We'll be actually, we're in the eighth week of ordinary time as I speak. Oh, and Snickers is just wanting to come on up here. So I think I probably should just sign off. But I hope to see you at Mass. Don't wear your clothes backwards. There's no color requirement in any way in this regard. Besides, Snickers not wearing collar clothes. He's just got a collar on, and it's blue. So that's not a liturgical color. So we're all good. I hope to see you this weekend. God bless you all. Bye-bye. Snickers, what are you doing? Okay, thanks. Yeah, I know you want to kiss me. But I know that you've been licking all kinds of other things, too. Have a good day, everybody. Bye-bye.